What's going on, guys? Welcome to today's video. Today we're doing a full day of eating. As you can tell, I feel like I look leaner. Do I? Like my face looks leaner? Feel free to compliment down below, you know, just make your boy feel good. Anyways, today we actually have an appointment at 11 a.m. I'm pretty sure I'm getting my permanent veneers in. I was kind of thrown off by how soon it was. We just uploaded the video for the temporary veneers last week, and now it's only been like a week and like 2-3 days, and I'm already getting I should be getting my permanents in today. So we're gonna try and do a full day of eating, a bunch of business stuff, workout stuff, and the veneer process today, all in one video. Today, we're starting off breakfast. So my macros right now, I'm actually doing a 3-1 low carb to high carb split right now. I'm doing 140 grams of carbs 3 days in a row. I'm actually on my third day of 140 carbs. Tomorrow, I'll get my high day of 180. So I've been keeping everything pretty clean in these final stages of the cut. We have the Sara Lee Delight 45 calorie bread. Two slices of this is 18 grams of carbs. We have the uncured turkey bacon, reduced fat, and then we have the egg substitute because they ran out of egg whites. Pretty much the same macros as egg whites. And then of course we got the pico to give it that omelet feel. So this is the first meal of the day, and we're gonna eat this and head to the dentist.
Okay, live from Aruba, Aruba. I need my respect and I need moolah. Ogura cheese, young Ghana angel with the features like I'm Sudanese.
All right, guys, so for meal one, we have the Sara Lee Delight 18 carb for two slices bread. This is a diet hack right here, or a diet saver. The I can't believe it's not butter, zero calories spray. Have that. We have a cup of egg whites with pico de gallo on the inside and spinach, and then we have two strips of turkey bacon. This meal comes out to 30 grams of protein, 18 grams of carbs, and 4 grams of fat. So you're getting a lot for a little, if that makes sense.
I have an appointment at 11 a.m.
Coker, C-O.
Hey, what's up, man?
Good, bro.
What's going on? How are you?
I'm good, man. How are you?
Good, good. Is there something going on with any of your temps, or?
I had an appointment today at 11.
Okay.
All right, so I thought I was gonna get my permanents in today, but I think it's just gonna be a checkup to see how these temps have been treating me. So I think we'll probably try and get the feedback from the temps for the first, like, I guess 1.5 weeks. That way they can make the adjustments, and my permanents are like perfect for my teeth. So let's see.
They're preparing.
Oh, okay. Is it like? So what, I've always wanted to know, is it porcelain?
Yes.
Okay.
It's called porcelain.
Okay.
All right. Well, it'll cost some. There's going to be a mouthwash. You're going to need you to squish it around.
Mm-hmm.
And then you're good.
He's just gonna give me a mouthwash. See, I've been scared to use mouthwash because I thought it was gonna stain my teeth, but I'm sure he's gonna give me like a clear version of mouthwash to clean them off.
This mouthwash, it's really good for your gum. Because we want your gum to stay clean and healthy while you're putting those steps.
All right, guys, so I just had that moment on prep when I'm in a different car. We'll get to that in a second. But I just had one of those moments in prep where if I didn't eat, I was gonna kill everything in sight or kill everyone in sight. So we stopped by Chick-fil-A. I picked up, and this is a tip for you guys, for those of you guys who are dieting and you need something to eat on the go and you don't trust the macros at certain establishments like me. Excuse me. The grilled market salad from Chick-fil-A, ask them to remove all the fruits, all the extra stuff, and just literally just leave grilled chicken breasts and lettuce. Great fill you up meal, gets you over, holds you over into your next meal. I literally told them to remove the berries, all the fruits, all the nuts, all that stuff, and they literally just left the chicken breasts, the shredded chicken breasts, and the leaves. And then I asked for the light Italian the light Italian dressing. This has 1 gram of 1 gram of fat, 3 grams of carb in this entire packet, so it's pretty good on macros too. But as I finish this, I'm gonna talk about my car situation. So we went to Austin last weekend, or last week, and this is what happened. So yeah, that happened, which then led to us kayaking the following day. We were kayaking, me, Casey, Jazzy, Chris, we were kayaking and we were kind of doing like a race, and we were actually losing the race, me and Casey, and I decided to step on the gas a little bit, which meant paddling a lot more. My keys were in my life jacket, where they told me to keep my keys and my wallet and my phone. I had my life jacket tied really tight. Somehow it fell out of my life jacket into the lake. I saw it go down into the lake. It was like slow motion. I was gonna jump in there and get it, but if you guys know, or if you guys are familiar with Austin and Lake Lady Bird, that water is absolutely disgusting. It's so green. You can't even, if I were to stick my head in it and try and open my eyes, I probably wouldn't have seen anything. Plus, I'm also very scared of like deep, deep lakes when I don't know what the hell is at the bottom of them. So I could pretty much just let my keys follow. I let my keys fall to the bottom and tried to go to Range Rover Austin. Couldn't get that situated. They were going to charge me $3,000 just to get my key expedited in 2 to 3 business days and reprogram my key. So I was able to find a friend in Houston who claims he could have done it, or who claims he could do it. And Sharple, he's been working on my cars for a while. He actually drove to Austin, towed my vehicle back to Houston, put it in his shop, and now he's been working on it since I think Friday or since Saturday. So for the time being, I'm driving around this Porsche Cayenne, which is a really good, really nice car. 2020 Porsche Cayenne. Makes me miss my old car. My old car makes me miss the Porsche days, but I'm still Range Rover for life. So just wanted to kind of touch up on that. I mean, I get a lot of DMs, Instagram DMs, because I snap a lot, or IG story a lot when I'm in my vehicle, and people pay attention to that shit. So that's the backstory. Moral of the story, you guys are probably gonna ask, what about your spare key? Well, my dumbass didn't make sure the dealership gave me 2 spare keys, or 2 keys, when I bought the vehicle. So that is my fault. So moving forward, I'm getting 2 keys with this next purchase, which I'm paying like $1,400 for this entire thing, to get my Range Rover back to like working condition and have 2 keys on me. I've spent $2,000 just to get like my shit replaced. So I've definitely learned my lesson. So moral of the story, make sure you have your spare key. Bring it somewhere, maybe bring it with you, or leave it at home where you know someone else can get it and bring it to you. That way, you're not in a situation like I am, where we're paying a shit ton of money just to get a key back.
Well, she went to go change.
Okay.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Up to my mom's house. So this is the home I grew up in. I'll show you guys my room. You haven't seen my room. Oh, you haven't seen my room before. This is the room. So all the magic happened.
Ronald Weasley.
As a young kid, always bring all the girls home, and you know, play board games with them, and high five and all that stuff, and patty cake. It's my I lived here until like I was probably about 22, and I finally moved out, got my own apartment.
LeBron James.
Hello.
Have you met
Sam
before?
Yeah, Sam.
Is your Mother's Day gift? I was gonna bring you the blue backpack, but it was so out of my way.
So
I'm gonna bring it this week. The blue backpack?
You need some light?
What are you doing? Just have this conversation.
Thank you all. Then Sandra's gifts are over there.
You don't remember them?
No. Thank you.
I do.
My mom actually works at a hospital, and she does respiratory therapist. Or she's a respiratory therapist.
Mm-hmm.
So she's been
taking care of the
COVID-19 patients, like hands on. She's been able to, like, I guess, paint a good image of like how it's been at the hospitals and stuff like that. And it's pretty crazy. Just thought I'd share that fact with you guys. You have anything else to say?
No, thank you so much for the gift. I am so proud to be your mom and your sisters too.
I'm proud to be your son and the brother of Sandra. All right, so we just put up to distribution. Got my boy Ant here. About to dig into the third meal. Had to drop off a couple of stuff. For the third meal today, we're having some rice, veggies, cauliflower rice. I got that in here with some fajita meat that I built. Some fajita chicken that I grilled yesterday, and we have some spinach that pretty much evaporated when I microwaved. Stuff's not bad. Ant doesn't like it. I don't know how you don't like cauliflower rice.
It's because I only eat it when I need to. I can't just eat it like, you just be eating it like.
I mean, this tastes like rice to me.
Yeah, no, you're tripping.
It does. It's like.
It's too like soft for me to think like it's. Like rice.
The thing with prep and dieting to the extreme like this is that there's gonna be a point where you're gonna have to start imagining things that look the same. When they're in your mouth, you start imagining other things. Like if I wanna imagine like a burger right now, I'll imagine a burger. But in reality, I'm eating this. So it's just as simple as chili cheese fries, good. American cheeseburger, onions, cheese, You just have to keep imagining shit as you're eating it. Trust me, it makes dieting 10 times easier. Alright guys, so usually when I know I'm about to have a fucking phenomenal workout and I'm very, 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 very behind on my carbs, keep in mind, I'm not like 2 weeks out from a show. I'm not 4 weeks out from a show. I'm not even 6 weeks out from a show. The show that I'm actually planning on doing, unless things change, it's gonna be December 11th in LA. So I'm gonna enjoy, even though I'm on super low carbs, I've only had 30 carbs today. I have 140 carbs to hit for today. I'm going to enjoy this Rice Krispie treat from the gas station. 6 grams of fat, almost 50 grams of carbs, 2 grams of protein, and then we're also gonna do this Monster energy drink. I know it's kind of weird to see me drinking, well, for one, to see me drinking Monster, and then for two, to see me drinking an energy drink, but this is my third day of 140, and I am definitely feeling the low carbs, so hopefully this brings me back to life and helps me get a fucking amazing back workout today. See you guys at the gym.
But I better get whipped with the pistol clip. Nigga talking that shit, now I'm talking my shit. Get on my dick, what in my hip, load in my clip. Cannabis, rolling my spiff. Hannibal, look what I did. Edible, got the bungees, but I got the bungees. I'ma double this shit, but I better get whipped with the pistol clip. Nigga talking that shit, now I'm talking my shit. Okay, East Atlanta playboy, don't got much to say, boy. Cradle to the grave, and it's been like this since a slave boy. It ain't shit to pull up, pick the fucking tool up. Screaming hallelujah, pushing daisies in some tula. With a dick, so you in a minute, nigga, put you in some air. Anybody get a room, get anybody get. Shot to the top, nigga popping the shit. Got the drop on your crib in the spot where you live. You can talking and shit, nigga, stop it. I'm a god, I'm a king, I'm a giant. Nigga, not trying. 40 my side. East side guy, better been more white. DIY, DIY, I'ma try, I'ma die for what I believe in. We like to feast and I like to eat cannibal meat. I am not an animal, a beast. Riding with a hammer on a seat. Shotgun, shotgun, hand of my heat. Bad man, none of my freedom. Nigga, get life with the white folks beat. Online beef, not my motif. 4-5 me, ta-ta, go sleep. Don't mind little old me, little OG, J-I-D, I came in on the bull seat. May I be the cold nigga with the most heat. Niggas, no, bro, you don't know me. Bro. Get on my dick, 40 my hip, load of my clip. Cannabis, cannabis, roll of my spliff. Hannibal, Hannibal, look what I did. Edible, edible, got the bungees, but I got the bungees. I'ma jump on this shit, but I better get whipped with the pistol clip. Nigga, talking that shit, now I'm talking my shit. Get on my dick, 40 my hip, load of my clip. Cannabis, cannabis, roll of my spliff. Hannibal, Hannibal, look what I did. Edible, edible.
All right, so here is my raw physique update. No chest pump, just a back pump, slight arm pump. I am holding on to a bit of water. And that's because my water intake has been complete shit the last 2 to 3 days. Today I've actually been doing a really good job about drinking a lot of water, as opposed to the previous 2 days on low carbs. I've kind of just been neglecting water, which is not good. I usually aim to get at least a gallon of water per day. Today I'm already a gallon in, and I'm gonna finish that other gallon right there before I go to sleep. But here is a raw physique update. Front. So I'm weighing in around 215 pounds. I'm down about 5 points, 5 points, 5 pounds since I started this prep. The trip to Austin kind of set me back a little bit, I'm not gonna lie. I had a 3-day diet break. That's probably another reason why I'm holding on to more water than usual. Up until that trip, I kind of felt a lot, I felt really dry. Today I don't feel as dry, but I'm not gonna stress about it. I know I can change that with just some cardio, my water intake, sort of just watching what I eat and just sticking to cleaner, leaner, and healthier whole foods, as opposed to the junk food that you kind of throw in there just to kind of hit your macros, even though I did have that Rice Krispie today. But I'm about to do some cardio. Had a solid workout. My shirt's pretty drenched in sweat, so I'm feeling pretty good. I'll feel pretty good after this workout. But that's my physique update for today. I'll see you guys at home. Alright guys, so just got home from the gym, and I have two amazing packages. It's funny that I'm calling them amazing because I have no idea what they are, but I know it's going to be amazing. So, first package. Oh yes! Yes! Let's go! It's funny how I went from being anti-caffeine to ordering one of the strongest coffees in the world, express shipped to my house. So as you guys know, come on over here. As you guys know, I have this espresso machine, and for the longest time, as I was like easing back into coffee, I started using these things, and honestly, it's not even the caffeine strength that gets me, that annoys me, it's the taste of Keurig coffee. Keurig coffee doesn't have enough of that coffee taste in it, and it kind of tastes like watered down coffee. As opposed to this one, or in comparison to this one tastes like some real shit, like some real good coffee. I'm definitely gonna start my morning off with this tomorrow morning. These are the flavors I get, because I've been asked that before. The Ocadio, Milazio, and the Stormy one. The cool thing about these, I think that, yeah, it has the strength on it. So it has 8 out of 11. 6 out of 11 and 7 out of 11. So this is the strongest one. I'll definitely probably start with the weakest one and kind of work my way up. Lately I've been doing like 3/4 to half a cup of coffee every morning. I probably won't finish a cup, but I love the taste of coffee. Even when I went on my caffeine cleanse, I was still doing decaf coffee every single morning. Over here, I think this is the sample. I'm pretty sure this is a sample. So we're gonna open this, hopefully my address isn't showing. We're gonna open this mother effer up, and I have an idea what this may be, but at the same time, I don't have an idea. So if that makes sense, we're on the same wavelength right now, then maybe you understand what I mean. But bro, how the fuck? Oh. Ooh, I got two. Got two of these motherfuckers. Boom. Bam. So, like I said, not really sure what this is, but I have a good idea. And if it is what I think it is, I'm pretty excited. Oh my God. Are you guys ready? You guys ready for this? I don't think y'all are ready. Boom. Look at that. That's what you call beauty, baby. Let's fucking go. So that's one. Oh, she sent me two of the same ones. Whew. That is absolutely beautiful, man. Absolutely beautiful. Damn, so be on the lookout for these. I'm gonna go ahead and tell y'all that these have already been finalized. These have already been okayed. These are the final samples. These are gonna go into production and they'll be out very, very soon. Damn, look at that. That's so sick. That's so sick. Fuck. Damn. Damn. Want one? No. Hell yeah. I gave one to Sam. Other Sam's gonna kill me. Damn, I can't wait, man. So these are obviously like the little flat. I'm about to use this tomorrow, man. See, this is gonna promote me to drink water, so I can just be like, and market it and shit. But yeah, be on the lookout for these. There's another package I'm supposed to be getting in today, but you guys will probably see that in the next video or on my Instagram story. But I'm gonna put all this shit away and we're gonna hop into the final meal of the day. We're gonna be trying a brand new flavor. I know it's 7:30 p.m. or actually it's 8 p.m. at night right now. It's the fucking daylight saving is throwing me off. But I just picked up a new flavor of Kodiak cakes from Target. So one thing that I've noticed that Target is the only place that has like the wild new flavors of Kodiak cakes. I feel like they have a good deal with like Kodiak cakes to where they get everything first because it takes a while for H-E-B and all the other grocery stores to get it. But we have these strawberry chocolate chip power cakes, waffle and flapjack mix. I'm probably gonna make waffles with these. So I'm gonna do a serving of this. I have about 60 carbs left for the day. Actually, I have about 50 carbs. Oh, I can't count. I have 60 carbs left for the day. So we're gonna do a serving of this, which is 53 grams of protein. I mean, 53 grams of Kodiak cake powder, sorry. I'm so hungry, I can't even think right. So we're gonna stop at 53. Shit. And then we're gonna come over here. And usually when I mix protein powders into my pancake mix, I try and find a flavor that kind of resembles the pancake mix I'm using. So we have the strawberry milkshake, which is an excellent tasting protein shake. So I'll do a full scoop of that in here. And usually for me, it gets kind of hard to put that on something and make sure it bakes or cooks correctly. So I'll get a little bit of baking powder. A tiny bit, because if you put too much, it'll fuck up the entire thing and it'll taste like absolute chemicals. So we'll do a little bit of baking powder, just a tiny bit of baking powder. That should be enough, maybe one more, since there's so much protein powder in here. Like, that should be enough. We'll do that amount of protein or baking powder, add some water. And then mix it up. I'm gonna give you guys a TTR, which is a taste test review, in case you didn't know what that meant. And I'll let you know how this tastes in a little bit. All right, so the 53 grams of this mixed in with 32 grams of this gave me all of this. And now I'm about to give you guys a taste test review of the strawberry chocolate chip Kodiak cakes mixed in with the strawberry milkshake 1UP Nutrition. So one thing that I did notice, whenever you add in protein shake or protein powder, It does remove like some of the fluffiness from the pancake, but when you're in a diet and you're this far into a diet, anything tastes good. Anything that's just not cauliflower rice and chicken and shit tastes good. So here we go. Wow. I'm gonna try to give you guys an accurate description of what this tastes like. It's a sensation of strawberry at first, and then it ends up with chocolate chips. And the chocolate chips isn't that strong, but you can still kind of taste the chocolate chips at the end. But honestly, if I were going to give you guys a rating, even though I did add this in, I can still kind of taste this. I think it tastes better when you mix in like the buttermilk with like just like ordinary protein, as opposed to mixing in all this random shit. This came out to 6 grams of fat, 40 grams of protein, and 42 grams of carbs. So this is my final meal of the day. Actually, it really is. I'm about to make some egg whites and turkey bacon, but that'll be my final meal of the day. And that's pretty much gonna wrap up this full day of eating. I'm actually not gonna eat this right now. I'm gonna go shower and come back down and eat this. But thank you guys for watching this video. Few things before I end this video. We're restocking all the high demand shirts from the last launch on April 25th. I kinda wanted to address a situation. So with our belts, we boldly stated on the website when people purchased the belts that there was gonna be a 4 to 6 week delay due to the COVID-19. We still are experiencing that delay, but the good news is that we're supposed to be getting our shipment of belts in this week, the week of the, what's today? The 11th? The week of the 11th. So hopefully by the end of this week, we'll have all our belts in stock and we're gonna be working 24 hours a day, 7 days a week to get all our orders out to you guys ASAP. So the belts are available on our website right now for pre-order if you wanna purchase one and lock one in before they sell out, because they always sell out. Next topic, the backpacks. The backpacks were already a pre-order. We hyped it up as a pre-order. We mentioned that it was a pre-order multiple times. And of course, you're always gonna get those people that don't read and don't see that stuff, which is okay, I understand. Sometimes you're just excited and you buy the thing without like reading everything. But it was a pre-order. But the good news is that we should be getting the backpacks in by May 20th. So that week, the week of May 20th, we'll be shipping all the backpacks out to all the people that purchase. And we'll be doing a restock on a limited amount of backpacks that comes in with that order as well. The shirts that were in high demand from the last launch, April 25th, the orange tie-dye shirt, the rainbow tie-dye shirt, and then the icon tee, the globe with the Anaka Power and colorful letters. Those three shirts will be restocking this week, so be on the lookout for that. Other than that, I hope you guys enjoyed today's video. I love you guys. I'll see you on the next one.